Thomas has compiled a notable record, winning 19 of his 21 fights with one loss and one draw. He has scored 11 knockouts and was stopped once. Benton, who was born in Philadelphia 30 years ago, is ranked number 5 among the middleweights. He has won 11 of his last 12 bouts, dropping a split knot to Hurricane Carter recently at the Garden. In all, Benton has won 47, lost 8, and fought one draw. He has racked up 27 KOs and has not been stopped. Benton stands 5 feet 10 with Thomas an inch taller. At the commission weigh-in today, Thomas was 164 and a half, Benton 162. Now all ready to take the show on the road, Genial Johnny Addy.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. In the ring at the present time, ladies and gentlemen, one of the hottest punchers in the middleweight division, middleweight contender from Paterson, New Jersey, Reuben Hurricane Carter. Also here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest boxers of all time, the former featherweight king, Willie Pep. Come on up, Willie Pep.
Where's Willie? Oh, here he is. Great boxer.
Here he is, one of the greatest, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, Willie's in good shape.
And also here tonight, former heavyweight king, Jersey Joe Walcott. Come on up.
Jersey Joe doing a wonderful job on the youth board over in New Jersey. A tremendous job he is doing.
Here's Pappy himself, Jersey Joe Walcott. Now, ladies and gentlemen, 1 week from tonight, heavyweights will be featured. Seventh-ranking heavyweight contender, Zora Foley, and his opponent, recent winner over Cleveland Williams, he's eighth-ranking contender, Ernie Terrell, 10 rounds, 1 week from tonight. Now, here are the ring officials assigned by the New York State Athletic Commission. The judges, Frank Forbes, Joe Armstrong. The timekeeper is Freddie Abatello. Counting for the knockdowns, Bonnie Smith. The referee for the main event, Mark Kahn. 10 rounds. Introducing from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He's wearing white trunks. He weighs 162. George Benton. Benton. His opponent from Chicago, Illinois. He's wearing black trunks. He weighs 164 and a half. Alan Thomas. Thomas. Main event, 10 rounds.
Carefully, boys. Keep both hands free at all times when you're punching. Do not hold with one hand and hit with the other. Is that clear? When I see you locked in a clinch, I'm going to tell you to break. I want each of you to stop punching immediately and take a step back. That's understood. Now watch your fouls, and I expect a clean bout at all times. Shake hands and good luck.
Scoring here in New York on a rounds basis with a supplementary point system, if the rounds come out even. They're wearing 8-ounce gloves. The three knockdown rule is in effect, as is the mandatory 8 count. And as you can see, there are now 4 ring ropes in New York. Thomas with the black trunks, Benton with the white trunks. Benton, the cagey campaigner. Thomas, best punch we're seeing for the first time, by the way. His best punch is supposed to be his right hand, which he sets up an opponent for with his left, as he's doing now. Benton, as you will note, along the way knows all the tricks of the trade. Thomas, 5 feet 11, 164 and a half, a little on the lean side. Benton, 5 feet 10, 162. Benton is laying back, trying to let the youngster make a mistake, as he did a moment ago, so Benton could counter. It's a long left hand that Thomas has. Benton trying to stay just out of range. taking the jabs hard. One minute to go in round one. The black trunk, Benton from Philadelphia in white. 10-round middleweight feature at Madison Square Garden. Thomas has been more aggressive here in round one. 10 seconds to go in round one. Round two at Madison Square Garden. On the left is George Benton in the white trunk from Philadelphia. And there's Alan Thomas in the black trunk from Chicago. The referee is Mark Thomas. So far it has been Thomas' aggressiveness and mostly his left jab against Benton's counterpunching. Benton's second appearance in the Garden. He was terribly disappointed when he lost to Ruben in May. Split decision. But he is getting off slowly again tonight. First real clinch of the fight, it's over in Thomas's corner. Round's about half over. A big bomb thrown over there by Benton. Thomas took it well. You see by Thomas's moves that the youngster knows what it's all about in there. He keeps those elbows up pretty good. Rat a tattoo with the jab by Thomas. Now Benton's coming back a little bit. Bell ends round two, and we go to the corner with Alan Thomas, who was born in Tuskegee, Alabama, February 14th, 1941. In the corner with him, facing him head on, is trainer Ray Barnes, an ex-fighter. On the right-hand side, Saul Gold, a man about boxing for a good many years who knows the game from all angles. And on the left-hand side, swabbing off the face is Freddie Fierro, whom we first met when he was helping train Big Khan for the Joe Louis fight back in 1941. On the other side of the ring, we have George Benson, who was born in Philadelphia May 15, 1933. In his corner, facing him, is manager Herman Diamond. On the right-hand side, trainer Joe Rose. And on the left-hand side, another popular man in Philadelphia boxing, Milt Bailey. Incidentally, Thomas was a great all-around athlete, might have been a ball player with the White Sox if he had wanted to. Here's the bell for round three. Thomas, the black trunks, Benton, the white. Benton has opened up a little bit in this round. One minute to go in round three. Benton has quite a coterie of Philadelphia adherents who have come up to see this fight. Garden, George Benton in the white trunks, Alan Thomas in black. Thomas got off winging in the first two rounds. Benton came back in the third. Here we are in the fourth. Thomas going southpaw, leading with the right hand. Mark Kahn is the referee. the veteran, Benton is letting the youngster, Thomas, make the mistakes and hot-shotting him. On Thomas' behalf, we'll say he's been the more aggressive of the two and has kept up a steady pace. Get away. Keeps them in there. About 40 seconds remain in round four. Coming along fine and enjoying tonight's fight at Bryn Mawr Hospital in Bryn Mawr, Pennsylvania. See you real soon, Sonny. Coming up to round five at Madison Square Garden, Alan Thomas of Chicago on the right in the black trunk, George Benton of Philadelphia in the white trunk. There have been no knockdowns, and the fight is reasonably close. Been the fire of the youngster Thomas and the wiliness and counterpunching of the veteran Benton. Thomas's corner is yelling underneath, meaning go for the body. Seconds to go on round five. There's rings the bell. Round six at the Garden on the left. George Benson, the white trunk. Alan Thomas in the black trunk. Mark Kahn, the referee. Benson seems to be willing to take many of those left jabs while guarding against Thomas's right hand, which is his good punch. Also, if Benson can make Thomas miss a left jab or keep throwing it, he can counter over it with his right hand, which he has been doing. Thomas's corner with Benton having his back to the rope. Next Saturday, the fight of the week returns to Madison Square Garden for an important 10-round heavyweight match between veteran Zora Foley and fast-rising Ernie Terrell. Foley has beaten such heavyweight headliners as Eddie Machen, Mike DeJohn, Henry Cooper, and Nino Valdez. In his last outing, he bested Bob Clarue. Overall, he has won 63 out of 72 with 35 knockouts. Terrell is 6 feet six and leaped into prominence in April when he outslugged hard-punching Cleveland Williams. A hard hitter with unusual speed for a big man, Terrell has won 30 out of 34 with 16 knockouts. Heavyweight Zora Foley and Ernie Terrell next Saturday on the Fight of the Week, brought to you by the Gillette Safety Razor Company and by Robert Burns. Here's round seven of Madison Square Garden. On the right is Alan Thomas in the black trunks. On the left, George Benton in the white trunk. Benton from Philadelphia, Thomas from Chicago, Mark Kahn is the referee. Thomas got off fast in the first couple of rounds, but Benton has been coming on with heavier punching. Round seven of a 10-rounder with the issue very much in doubt. Thank you. Thomas's corner, they're yelling to their fighter, move your head. Fenton's corner, rather quiet. Seconds to go in round seven. There's the bell. Round eight at Madison Square Garden. Alan Thomas of Chicago, the black trunk, 164 and a half. George Benton of Philadelphia, 162 in the white trunk. Thomas is ranked ninth among the light heavyweights. Benton, number five among the middleweights, in case you didn't hear it earlier. Boys did a nice job with the elbows in that clinch. Landing the big punches again. About half a minute left in round eight of a 10-rounder. Thomas, by the way, is the protege of heavyweight champion Sonny Liston. Bell ending round eight. preliminaries tonight in the lightweight bout. Ricky Nelson of the Bronx won a unanimous decision over Barney Barnes of Puerto Rico. That was six rounds. In another six-round middleweight match, Willie Jones won a unanimous decision over Jimmy Harrison. Jones from Newark, Harrison from Philadelphia. Another six-round middleweight bout, Lucius Benson of Brooklyn won out a TKO at the end of the fifth round over Richie Hill of the Bronx. And in a four-round lightweight duel, Russell Shulars of Paterson, New Jersey, and Felix Morales of Puerto Rico fought a draw. We're happy to report that Rose Cohen, the popular ticket manager of the Garden Boxing Club, is recovering from her illness at Polyclinic Hospital. Doctors there are highly optimistic about Rose's condition and think she'll be with us real soon again. Coming up to round nine at Madison Square Garden, George Benson of Philadelphia, the white trunk, Alan Thomas of Chicago in black. There have been no knockdowns. It has been a duel mainly of Alan Thomas's sharp left jab, which is a good one, and Benton's wiliness, his experience, and a good overhand right. Mark Kahn, the referee, hasn't had too much to do in this bout. He's fairly free of clinches. Nice bit of boxing there by Benton and a lot of zealousness by Thomas. One minute to go in round nine. There have been no knockdowns in the play. Ten seconds to go in round nine. The bell. Tenth and final round at Madison Square Garden. Referee Mark Kahn out in the center, waiting for George Benton with the white trunks and Alan Thomas in the black. No knockdowns in the fight. Thank you.
2 minutes left in the fight. Casey John is late. Thomas from Chicago. Ninth-ranked light heavyweight. Black trunk. Weighs 164 and a half. Bentham from Philadelphia, 162, is the number five ranking middleweight. Thomas got off quick and ran up a lead in the first couple of rounds, but Bentham has been coming on since. Pressure on all the way, has forced the pace. Benton has done the harder counter punching. Scoring in New York on the round basis. Two judges and the referee. 1 minute to go in the fight now, and some of the crowd shouts to applaud. It has been a good one. Heavyweight, Zora Foley and Ernie Terrell. Another fine match put on by Teddy Brenner. Come on, 30 seconds left in the fight now. Slight cut beside the left eye of Alan Thomas. Seconds now. There's the final bell of a good fight here at Madison Square Garden. Now we're waiting for the decision. The cards are in the hands of the officials. Dan Dowd and Frank Morris from the commission, along with Jack Duberstein. Johnny Addy has them now to announce it. Here's John.
Judge Frank Forbes has it 6-3, one even, Benton. Referee Mark Kahn, 6-4, Benton. The other judge, Joe Armstrong, 8-2, Benton. Winner by unanimous decision, Georgie Benton.
Very gracious, although disappointed, Alan Thomas goes over to congratulate Herman Diamond, the manager of George Benton, and George. There's George with his handlers, Joe Rose, Milt Bailey, Herman Diamond, and it was a good fight, a good win for Benton, and Alan Thomas, a good loser, probably learned a lot by it.